I guess is maybe a way to put it. Like you start to get sprinting out of the blocks, and then you find yourself right back.
Does this feel different than last year, even when this team struggled?
Yeah, because I mean, last year we was one of those teams fighting for the spot. So you know, we was on the bubble, we was off the bubble, we're not in. We win the next two games, we're in, and so it's like. Then you really feel like you are seriously fighting for your life. Now it's kind of like, I don't think guys get that, you know. I think some of us think that, you know, we already in and, you know, everything's going to take care of itself, but we're not in yet. And it could easily go south if we don't turn it around.
Really, one of the Arkansas guys said they thought you guys got tired down the stretch, and that's why some of the free throws were missed.
Tired. Sometimes they don't go in. We've had it in the past where one game everybody's free throws go in, and the next game they split. The next game everybody misses, and it's just depends on the day, I guess.
What effect does that have on momentum when you all take the lead there at the end and the free throws just go wrong?
I mean, it takes a lot from you, especially when you know you can make them.
Well, you were dunking tonight, but there were a lot of guys who missed a lot of shots between, you know, a foot, 2 feet, that kind of stuff. You guys missed a lot of layups, maybe not you, but collectively as a team. Why does that happen? How does that happen? Just one of those nights?
Hits the rim wrong, rolls out. There was a lot of bodies there trying to go through contact, and, you know, the ball just in the right spot and it just rims out. And, I mean, that's what it seemed like that was going on.
What is it about Arkansas from your vantage point that makes them such an even matchup with you all?
They're reckless. They're a reckless team. You can't really, you know, with other teams that, you know, are more organized and you know what they're going to run, you know what they're going to do at certain times, it's way easier to play because, you know they're not going to take a contested three. This team, you have no idea. They can pull from half court and then, you know, they got a 50-50 chance it's going to go in. So, I mean, it's super hard to play against teams like that where, you know, the coach just lets them, you know, just ball. And those guys do a really good job at what they do.
Is it safe to say you don't want any part of them in the SEC tournament, or do you want a chance to knock them off this year?
You got to. I hope you play them again. Two times, one at home, and, you know, lots at home. Anytime you get lost at home, you want to play that team again. I hope we get a chance to play them again just to see, you know, if they can win three.
There's a big step back tonight, Willie. Y'all said a big step back.
I don't think it was a big one. I think it's just a test. And it's a test for guys, you know, to really see if we're about this run. And if we are, then tomorrow, the sense of urgency in practice is going to be way different. The game against South Carolina, we'll see then. I mean, we can come out and play out of our minds, and nobody's going to ever remember we had this conversation. So it simply is just forgetting about this game and moving on. And, I mean, that's really all we can do at this point is learn, you know, what we did wrong and then take the positives of what we did and move on.
How confident are you that you guys will approach it that way, that you'll do it that way?
I'm approach it that way. I'm a preach, you know, for the team to approach it that way because, you know, me, Alex, JP, John Hood, you know, even Sam Malone and Brian has been there. We know exactly what's happening. It's a scary thing if you let it, go south.
Does it feel like that at all? Does it feel like last year in that way?
In a way, it does, but, you know, last year we was not even in the top 25, so we was, you know, fighting for the spot. And this year, you know, we're in the top 20, but it's not like, you know, that loss is going to set us back another. And it's like, you know, you almost got to win out just so you're safe, just so you know you're safe and you know that you can get in that tournament.
Cal said a couple guys didn't show up tonight.
I just think, you know, guys showed up. I'm not going to say guys didn't show up because I've had games where, you know, they said I didn't show up, and in my head I thought I was there. I just had, you know, some mental lapse that set me back, and, you know, that's what I think, that's all that happened is, you know, once you start, you know, making mistakes, and it's like a snowball effect. Next thing you know, you made another mistake. And not only are you getting, you know, talked to by the first mistake, now you're talking about the second mistake, and then now you're going to make another third mistake, and then next thing you know, you got to just take yourself out and, you know, take a step back real quick and then get your mind right and go back in. I mean, and that's how it is playing for Coach Cal, and you just got to realize that.
Thanks, Willie.